Welcome to the University of Rochester Pathology Video Series. This video will review the normal histology of the lung, including the structures associated with the alveoli, bronchioles, and bronchi. The current slide is an image of the alveolar spaces that make up most of the lung. The alveoli are lined by type 1 and type 2 pneumocytes. The type 1 pneumocytes are squamous, or flat, and constitute about 95% of the pneumocytes. Their flat and thin nature allows for the easy diffusion across the capillaries that is so integral to the function of the lung. The type 2 pneumocytes are cuboidal and constitute only about 5% of the pneumocytes. They produce surfactant, a detergent-like fluid that reduces surface tension and allows the lung to inflate much more easily, thereby reducing the work of breathing. The next image depicts a bronchiole. The bronchioles are less than 1 centimeter in diameter and make up the extensive distal dichotomous branching architecture of the lung. There is no cartilage associated with the bronchiole, only smooth muscle. Here, we can distinctly see the ciliary brush border that is characteristic of many of the body's epithelial linings. The rhythmic beating motion of the cilia moves mucus from the lungs upward toward the epiglottis, where it is swallowed. The final image depicts a bronchus. The bronchi are greater than 1 centimeter in diameter and connect the trachea to the bronchioles within the hilum of the lung. Unlike the bronchioles, the bronchi are also surrounded by a layer of cartilage in addition to smooth muscle and connective tissue. It is the bronchi that branch into smaller structures called bronchioles, eventually evolving into the air sacs called alveoli, which are the sites of oxygen and carbon dioxide exchange in the respiratory system. It is within a functional context that we can also come to understand the importance of the type 1 pneumocytes, which facilitate diffusion, as well as the type 2 pneumocytes, which facilitate the inflation of the lungs by producing surfactant. That concludes our review of the normal histology of the lung. Thanks for watching.